As the last of our gannets leave Aldney, disappearing off the Lesotech colony behind us, it just emphasises what an incredible year we've had in 2015, caring for our marine waters.
I think the most inspiring thing about the last year is that our number of regular volunteers nearly doubled to over 1,500, clearly showing that our new five-year strategy is inspiring people to get involved, connect to nature and take responsibility for it.
So for me, Yosin is particularly important because not only does it support a wide variety of animals and plants that we would see in a good chalk grassland, it's already got this amazing assemblage and we need to be here to preserve it and look after it. If wildlife organisations weren't here, then it would easily be lost.
We've worked with hundreds of volunteers to create wildflower meadows across the whole of Birmingham and the Black Country. We've now created our 40th. We're transforming grassland that looks like this to beautiful wildflower meadows buzzing with wildlife for everybody to enjoy.
Cheshire Wildlife Trust's highlight of 2015 is getting funding from the Heritage Lottery for Natural Futures, a four-year project about conservation volunteering that will help more people do more for wildlife in Cheshire.
Welcome to Icott Hill. This is Cumbria Wildlife Trust's newest reserve and it's only upland reserve. Here we have over 200 hectares, most of which is a SSSI. We're planning to improve the reserve for members of the public to visit. We're also carrying out a number of restoration projects to improve the diversity of the site.
Derbyshire Wildlife Trust has just started the second year of a five-year badger vaccination programme. This year we've been awarded £98,600 from DEFRA and we're working closely with the National Trust. We've already trained 60 volunteers over the winter and we want to beat our amazing 75% average vaccination rate last year.
Very exciting news from Devon Wildlife Trust. We've been at the heart of the reintroduction of beavers back into the English landscape for the first time for 400 years. We introduced them back into the river in February under a licence from Natural England. And ever since they've been thriving and we've now got baby beavers being born on the river for the first time.
Welcome to the River Froom in Dorset, part of the Dorset Wild Rivers project. We've spent 5 years restoring major rivers and wetlands, increased fish populations and created habitat for white-clawed crayfish. We've even seen an increase in the rare winterbourne mayfly on the South Winterbourne River. Thank you to all the volunteers who've put in 4,000 hours to make it all happen.
2014 was a great year for the Wild Ground project. We trained 6 adults in wildlife friendly grounds maintenance, 5 of whom gained employment in the environmental sector. This year, 2015, is proven to be just as successful and hopefully it will continue long into the future.
This year we've opened Inglebourne Valley Vista Centre.
With me, Yola Williams, and the sexiest lady in the Essex world.
All our nature reserve at Snow's Farm Nature Reserve, we created 15 structures similar to this, which are, you know, sort of medium-sized woody debris, leaky dams. Also on some of these side channels that are coming in from the spring line, which we've got behind us here, we've also filled with some of the coppice debris that we've done from our work as well, and also some of the bigger bits of timber. We've also been working with landowners upstream and downstream of the nature reserve, putting in similar structures with the neighbour downstream, and upstream we've put in some much bigger structures that have stretched across the whole of the floodplain.
Hi, a highlight for Gwent Wildlife Trust this year has been the trolley project. The River Trolley is a failing watercourse because of high nutrients and sediment loads. So this year we've been working closely with NRW and landowners to create new habitats within the trolley catchment that will address these issues.
This is Baldner Forest on the Isle of Wight, and it's here that Hampshire and Isle of Wight Wildlife Trust runs Woodland Therapy. It's a project for adults which promotes mental health and well-being. We use the forest school approach, which is known to develop self-confidence, self-esteem, independence and resilience. Some of our clients who live with long-term mental health conditions have really benefited from the sessions, and a third of them have reported that they rely less on formal support services since joining the group. The project is a great example of why people need nature.
Hi, I'm John Clark, Development Director at Herefordshire Wildlife Trust. Our big achievement this year was purchasing Birches Farm, our newest nature reserve and one of England's newest SSSI. It's a fantastic gem of wildflowers in the Herefordshire landscape, and we're really proud to take that site forward.
It's been a really busy year for the Herts and Middlesex Wildlife Trust, but one of our highlights was the opening of our forest school in Panshanger Park. Funded by Tarmac, the Forest School programme has seen groups of children from local primary schools coming to explore the woodland, experience lots of different skills and crafts, and learn about the wood and its wildlife. The Forest School at Panshanger Park brings learning to life and helps children connect with the environment around them.
This year, the Leicestershire and Rutland Wildlife Trust was delighted to see the construction of our new volunteer training centre at Rutland Water Nature Reserve. We'll now be able to deliver a variety of learning and volunteering activities, all designed to make a real difference to our natural heritage and promote skill sharing between people from all walks of life.
At Lincolnshire Wildlife Trust, we believe that it's really important that children connect with nature as they grow up. Our WildPlay brand, WildTime activities and wildlife watch groups are a key part of this. This year we were really proud that our Wildlife Watch Group at Wisby Nature Park won Wildlife Watch Group of the Year, and our Alford group came in highly commended.
Yeah! This is a great day, particularly because of this, the Norfolk Wildlife Trust. It was founded in 1926. 12 people got together about this coast. It is a great pleasure for me to be here on this great day.
November 2014 saw the beginning of the Eleanor Wheeler Living Landscape Project. This is a 3-year project funded by Wren and Dŵr Cymru, and we have £244,000 to spend on habitat improvements across the two river valleys. This includes tree planting, meadow management, and also the removal of Himalayan balsam on 21 kilometres of river. We're also engaging with the local community through talks, volunteering and also training opportunities.
Wildlife Discovery Centre at Huxley.
funded by the Heritage Lottery Fund and charitable trusts, built almost exclusively by volunteers. On course to be the greenest building in the Northeast. 2015 has been great for us. 2016 will be even better.
Attenborough Nature Reserve has long been seen as the gateway to the work of the Wildlife Trust here in Nottinghamshire. Over the last 12 months, we've made real progress with engaging with new audiences, including members of minority ethnic groups. We now want to use the experience and knowledge gained here to make the rest of our estate much more welcoming.
Hello and welcome to Abercamlow Bog Nature Reserve. I'm stood, as we speak, in a kettle hole. I'm slowly sinking, I think, but it's a wonderful nature reserve here. We've been looking after this nature reserve now for about 20 years, but this last 12 months we were left a wonderful legacy by this lady here, Mary Whitten, which has enabled us to purchase the nature reserve. And this means that it is now safe and we can look after it for future generations. Kids like this will be able to come here and stand in kettle holes like this in years to come.
Wildlife Trust highlights for this year have included the designation of 30 new marine protected areas around the coast and the seas of Scotland, the culmination of our fantastic 5-year Scottish beaver trial, which we hope will pave the way for beavers back in the UK in the future. We also took on a new nature reserve in the Isle of Orkney, Little Linger, which has 10% of the breeding population of grey seals in the UK. And more recently, we launched our 50 for the Future publication, 50 fantastic ideas, which will help transform Scotland for both people and wildlife in the future.
The Wild at Heart project has been set up by Sheffield and Rotherham Wildlife Trust and is funded by the Big Lottery. It aims to improve the well-being of local older people by providing over 50s with opportunities to take up new hobbies and meet each other and connect to the natural world. As we look to the future, we have the opportunity to work with Sheffield University to thoroughly evaluate the work we've done so far. Not only will this help us see which direction we want to take the project in, but will also provide evidence when securing further funding.
In August, hundreds of children rescued Soldier 10 from the trenches at Whitcliffe Common Nature Reserve and received a Woodland Medal for their bravery. Volunteers from Virgin Balloon Flights created a memorial wildlife garden, all thanks to funding from HLF's Understanding the First World War programme.
Rockpool rambles, shore search events, photography competitions, super low tide activities, coastal art exhibitions, television and radio appearances, interpretation boards, intertidal surveying and wildlife boat trips are just some of the activities SWT has been up to in its first year of coastal work.
Since taking on the roaches in 2013, our aim has always been to improve the footpaths on the site. Thanks to members of the public voting for us, we received €30,000 from IOCA, which we invested into over 300 metres of footpath, which we brought back into condition. This included over 50 metres of boardwalk installed by our volunteers.
And I've been working on the Networking Nature Project, which is funded by the Heritage Lottery Fund. We've been working with communities to inspire them to instil some on-the-ground action for wildlife. We've been working across allotment sites, schools, community spaces, creating things like community orchards, woodlands, creating wildlife ponds, even microhabitats, to enable people to enjoy wildlife and provide safer and more suitable environments for our wildlife in the greater community.
We've had another fantastic year. The herd's grown to nearly 340 head of cattle. We've got 50 goats and the 160 red deer are making huge biological differences. Biodiversity is benefiting from everything we do. We're having a great time introducing the public to our big grazing animals across the county.
This year, our Nature Tots has gone from strength to strength. We think it's so important to get kids out at a young age learning all about nature. And now we've got up to 90 tots coming to our sessions each week. And the parents seem to enjoy it just as much as the kids.
We started this project early 2014. We started with the help of a local dry stone mauler, Keith Ledger. He actually built the first 3 metres with myself and some of our inclusive volunteers. There's a very diverse group of volunteers on that project. The reason why it's been a really good project to work on is because I think it helps people actually come back down to the sort of the same rhythm as nature, because when you dry stone wall and you have to actually look at each stone, because each stone has a place, it has a face, a top and a bottom, so it actually helps people to slow down and get to actually, you know, think about what they're doing and looking at the stone all different angles.
Thank you.
Earlier this year, the Welsh Government had a consultation on the future of landfill tax in Wales. They're proposing removing the Landfill Communities Fund. However, we led a campaign with the six wildlife trusts in Wales, their members and supporters, and fronted by TV personality Yola Williams. And we were successful. We saved the Landfill Communities Fund in Wales. Hurrah!
The Wildlife Trust of South and West Wales are really excited about our newest nature reserve here at Llynfach in the South Wales Valleys. This glacier lake, cliffs and scree are home to rare montane species, water vole and an amazing variety of birds of prey. And thanks to a Biffa Award grant, we're now able to start bringing this SSSI into positive management.
This year we launched our first year-long Nature Skills traineeships, supported by the Heritage Lottery Fund. Over the next 3 years, 18 trainees like me will gain the practical, hands-on experience they need to develop their careers in the natural heritage sector.
This year we launched our Hedgehog Improvement Area project, with the aim of engaging urban and suburban communities with hedgehog conservation and having conversations about what we can all do in a patch of green space, no matter how big, to help hedgehogs. So far it's been a great success and conversations are being had up and down the country about hedgehog conservation, which is all we could have hoped for.
And here at Lowermore Farm, Wiltshire Wildlife Trust Nature Reserve, I've just been watching a family of otters, two adults and two cubs. Over the last 18 months, Lowermore Farm has turned into one of the best places in Britain to see wild otters. And families have been reporting sightings of these wonderful animals.
We're here at Blackhouse Woods, which we've just purchased off the back of our most successful ever appeal, raising over £200,000 from members and funding bodies. It's a great asset in our landscape scale conservation, and moving forward we're going to manage this site for people and wildlife.
Yorkshire Wildlife Trust launched a campaign to save Askham Bog Nature Reserve in York. The reserve was threatened by a proposed housing allocation adjacent to its northern boundary. With the support of our campaigners, York City Council heeded our collective concern, and for now, Askham Bog is safe.